was thinking about, because, you know, whenever I get food, I always get on Uber Eats. First of all, Uber Eats has its own markup, so you're always paying extra for your food, more than you'd pay if you actually went to the actual store. No, you could factor in fuel costs, like the cost of petrol, depending on where you're traveling. So maybe it balances out when you consider that. But, there's a place I want to go to that is not accessible, like, via delivery, like, Uber Eats doesn't deliver. It has a pickup option that you can order and then pick it up yourself. So yeah, I've never seen it before just because usually it just shows me the places that can deliver to my house. So I thought I'd get this beef burger bagel. I just want to try it. Patty, sweet cherry peppers, halloumi, sweet chili mayonnaise, onion mayonnaise, trimmings, I guess. I don't know what trimmings are. Like, I don't know. And chips or fries, as they say in the States. Call it fries over here. So I'm gonna drive over there and make this. And it's also for the adventure, you know. You know, the food might be mid, it might be mid, but it'd be nice just to go on a drive, put on some music. Go to a new place, see new things. Just get out the house, and see some new things. I'll let you know how that is, how that tastes. I need to relax. In terms of spending money on food. I need to relax. Making progress with my book, as always. Making progress. It's cool. You know, showing up every day is just what's important more than anything. Sometimes you don't feel like it. Sometimes you hit points where you're just like, you're not as enthusiastic, but you have the discipline to keep on keeping on. I'm getting really close, people. I'm getting close. If I achieve nothing else in my life, if I can just say I wrote a novel, full-length novel, wrote it myself, that's amazing. Even if it never sells, even if it never ever sells, it's okay. I can just look myself in the mirror and say I did it. You did it. I worked hard. To achieve that goal, it was that dream. It was a big dream of mine to write a novel. So it's been a big dream. code and cracked code. And it was the one that cracked code. Feeling very confident this time around. Chimaev and Robert Whittaker had a fight. Yikes. That match was brutal. Khamzat broke Whittaker's his jaw. It was disgusting. His teeth, like they showed his teeth, they were like misaligned. And it was terrible, guys. Blood all over the place. It was terrible. He was like, I'm happy, my family's happy. Like the Chimaev, the one that won, he was like, oh, it makes me happy, my family's happy, everyone's happy. He said he felt bad at first, but you know, he's like, I'm here to hurt people. It's my job to hurt people. But you know, it's sad. It doesn't usually happen that way. Serious injuries here and there in the UFC, combat sports in general, but you rarely see something that brutal. Usually it's like, you know, it just gets really bloody in the face, but you know. This was another level, dude. Yikes. Soccer, to be honest. I watch highlight reels on Insta when it comes to soccer. I've never been a big soccer fan, to be honest. But the highlights are always fun to watch. But sitting through a 90-minute match for me, eh. I'll sit through a very long boxing match. But when it comes to soccer, Who won? Let me check my comments. Yeah, it's the comment post was Barcelona 4 minutes. Let me shut my mouth. I don't know if it's a good team, a bad team. I don't watch soccer. is. It's just like families living in big houses, and at that point, can't live separate from each other. So it was an interesting point, this idea that, you know, in smaller homes, where you're forced to interact with each other, you're forced to share space, you're forced to share a lot of the same amenities and utensils and stuff. It forces you to engage with each other and interact, and you get closer as a result. You know, you get in arguments, you're just forced to say hello to people, talk, just engage with one another because the space is so small. Whereas in big houses where everyone has their own space, sometimes they might not be as close. I thought it was an interesting argument. I don't think it's necessarily... like, you're going to be distant from each other. If you have a big home, obviously there's things you can do to encourage interaction amongst family members. Like when it's dinner time, everyone must be at the table. You sit at the table and you talk. Contributes to the discussion, and family activities, you go out together, you do something like that. Actually, I think about it, yeah, that does sound cool. I don't know if I want a big house, just because, I don't know. I mean, I like the idea of having space, though. I like the idea of having room. So I think we wanted the big house for sure. There's so many things you can do to encourage engagement amongst your family. The benefit of having a small home is that you are kind of forced to interact, regardless of whether you want to or not. And I think you just get closer to the result. But there are downsides to that as well. You're forced to interact even if you don't want to. That's also the downside. Where you're like, when someone's being a bit much, you can't get away from them. I mean, you don't want to get away from your family, but like, you know, like let's say you and your wife just want some space. Maybe like siblings. I think siblings is a better example. Like if you're sharing a room with your sibling and you get into a fight, and still sharing a room, you know. And you constantly, maybe you're just two very different people, and it's hard to get along and then share things because you both just have your own way of doing things. And constantly clashing and stuff, that can be a serious problem sometimes. It teaches you to compromise, for sure. It teaches you to compromise, but sometimes, man, like, people are just different. Like, you have your own idea of what it means to be orderly and structured, so, like, when you walk into the room and you see certain things a certain way, you're like, damn, what is this? But then the other person, to them, it's like, it's not that big of a deal. Sometimes people are just different. There's pros and cons to sharing a space, small space, and pros and cons to sharing, having your own space in a big house. I guess it just depends on the person, the family, depends on the family. But I do think you should definitely encourage interaction, encourage family time. For sure, one question. I don't know why they made three of those. I thought the first one was kind of trash, to be honest. Some people said they liked it. I thought it was trash. It was mid at best. At best, like super mid. Super mid. But yeah, I thought it was kind of like, So then they made a second one. I didn't watch the second one. People watched the second one. They said it was okay. But the third one came out. Everyone said that was terrible. I don't know why these people subjected themselves to that. You couldn't pay me to go watch that. Well, you could pay me, actually. In fact, you don't even have to pay me that much. Yeah, you don't have to pay me that much, but you do have to pay me. I'm not gonna watch it for free. If you gave me a free ticket, I wouldn't go. But if you offered me money, I'd go. But it depends how much. It doesn't have to be that much, to be honest. Maybe like, $20, 20 rand, which would be around $15. Doing that good these days. Okay, let's say 200. Oh, it'd be $11. I was way off. It'd be $11.3. Yeah, give me $11. I might watch it. Give me 15. Okay, I'm just being honest. 11, I'll do it. I don't think I'll turn down $11. I'll watch Venom, The Lost Dogs. I think it's called The Lost Dogs. Venom. Yeah. The Lost Dogs. Or Dance. Dance. Would I watch it for $11? I don't know if that's enough. I'm trying to think. How much is my time worth? My time is worth a lot. Man, give me 20. Give me $20. I said my time is worth a lot, and I only increased the price by $20. That's hilarious. So I'm being reasonable. Give me $20, I'll go watch it. I'll go. I'll make the sacrifice. Give me. Maybe not 20, maybe, let's see. Yeah, 22. Give me $22.64, because that's 400 rand. 400 rand, I'll go watch Venom. The Lost Dogs. Because I know it's going to be trash. I know I'm going to hate it. So, if I'm going to suffer, like, pay me. I'm not going to suffer for nothing. Don't be ridiculous. Show by the Wayans family. It's called Papa's House. Same guy who made My Wife and Kids. Damon Wayans, or I can't remember his name, but that guy. Same guy who made My Wife and Kids. He's now got a show called Papa's House with his son, Damon Wayans Jr., I believe. I watched the trailer because I really like My Wife and Kids. So I was watching the trailer for Papa's House, and it was giving very similar vibes. I'm not a super fan of the premise. You know, it's about a divorced father. His married son moves next to him, and they engage with each other. I don't like watching stories about divorce, just because divorce is sad. But I don't know, I watched the trailer and I was like, this is interesting. I'd give it a shot. I'm worried because it's an all black cast, and I'm worried that they're gonna go super woke and just talk about the black experience and all this sort of stuff, which is so annoying, right? These black creators, they struggle to just tell stories without always hyper focusing on race. You know, you wish that you could just tell unifying stories that everyone can relate to, without always being like, I'm black, by the way, I'm black. It's like, we know, please. You remind us every second of every day. Please. So, I think it can be a good show if they don't lean into all that nonsense and just tell a good story that everyone, you know, it should be a family show that, you know, white, Asian, black, everyone can just come together and watch, and everyone can laugh together. We all get that because that's just part of the human experience. That's just part of the family experience. That's why certain shows are popular. I think that's what made My Wife and Kids work. Is I don't remember a single episode where they kind of made race a thing. I couldn't even think of one episode in that show where race was a matter of discussion. That's why it worked. It was just a family show about family. Family life. Like, you could be white and watch that and enjoy it. Just like I'm black and I can watch what's a good classic family show? You know, like According to Jim or something. I'm thinking about like the classics, like the 90s, maybe early 2000s. Watch it and you still relate, because it's like, whether you're a teenager, whether you're a mom, whether you're a dad, whether you're a brother or sister, like, you get it, you know, like, these are universal things that every human being can relate to, and that's why these shows work. When a show goes to Bogota and we're all black and we're suffering, everyone goes, oh my gosh, you know, you're making it for, like, this audience, like, this tiny audience. It's like, even amongst black people, some black people are tired of the whole narrative and they might zone out and be like, no, I don't want to watch this. And that's why I think black people just don't understand. Enough. But like I said, elements to it, the cost happens to be black, but it was just a good show. So since it's the same guy involved, Damon Wayans, and he looks like he's bringing heavily involved in the creative direction of the show, hopefully he retains the same philosophy he had when he made that show. We'll see. I'm rooting for it. I really want it to be good, because I like My Wife and Kids a lot. That was good. It was one of those rare shows where the man is the man of the house. They don't emasculate him. They don't turn him into a big dum-dum that everyone laughs at constantly, because he's a joke. You know, he's goofy, he's eccentric, but he's still very respectable and smart and race of the cost was irrelevant. It wasn't even like a thing that you thought. It was just a good show. You know, I hate when people just hyperfixate on the race. It means your show is probably not that good if you constantly have to focus on race. You know? But anyway. Make a good sitcom one day. I feel like people just don't know how to do it these days. They don't know how to do it right. I'd love to throw my head in the ring and make a good family show. I think I'd kill it too. I think it'd be hilarious. It'd be like a mixture of like Curb Your Enthusiasm and My Wife and Kids. Those are two of my favorite shows. Two of my favorite comedy shows. Yeah, I think it'd be sick. I don't know if it'd be family. Because Curb Your Enthusiasm is kind of vulgar and inappropriate in many ways. So, I don't know, it'd be unbalanced to strength. I definitely want it. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see. Anyway, I've rambled. Love and marriage and sustain them love and marriage and make him very, very happy. Thank you for blessing this person with the spirit of gratitude so he can give thanks for the wonderful things in my life and make every blessing divine peace continue and make even more blessings. Let your presence be felt in this person's life so that knowledge and power, that your relation with the universe will be there for them. Good health, long.